in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Good morning to you all. Amen. And a very warm welcome to you to our celebration of Mass this morning. We're offering our Mass this morning for Eamon Magnan, who died recently. And in the Gospel reading, feel it this morning in the Gospel, how much the Lord is just dying for people to hear his word and respond to it. But he does say that it can be difficult to let the word penetrate into our hearts. So this morning as we celebrate our Mass, let us open our hearts and minds and indeed our attitudes to the word of God and hear it. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Word of the Father, and you bring us your forgiveness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life. Let us pray. Let us pray this morning for a real openness to the presence of Christ among us. Enlighten, O God of compassion, the hearts of your children, sanctified by penance, and in your kindness, grant those you stir to a new sense of devotion, and a gracious hearing when they cry out to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Defied the order of the king. and prefer to forfeit their bodies rather than serve or worship any god but their own. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm is to you glory and praise forevermore, and it's every other line. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed, Lord God of our fathers. To you glory and praise evermore. Blessed your glorious holy name. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed in the temple of your glory. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed on the throne of your kingdom. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed and gaze into the depths. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed in the firmament of heaven. To you glory and praise forevermore. The Gospel proclamation. Praise and honour to you, Lord Jesus. Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Praise and honour to you, Lord Jesus.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. To the Jews who believed in him, Jesus said, "If you make my word your home, you will indeed be my disciples. You will learn the truth, and the truth will make you free." They answered, "We are descendants from Abraham, and we have never been slaves of anyone. What do you mean, you will be made free?" Jesus replied, "I tell you solemnly, everyone who commits sin is a slave. Now the slave's place in the house is not assured, but the son's place is assured. So if the son makes you free, you will be free indeed. I know that you are descended from Abraham, but in spite of that you want to kill me, because nothing I say has penetrated into you. What I, for my part, speak of is what I have seen with my father. But you put into action the lessons learned from your father." They repeated, "Our father is Abraham." Jesus said to them, "If you were Abraham's children, you would do as Abraham did. As it is, you want to kill me when I tell you the truth, as I have learned it from God. This is not what Abraham did. What you are doing is what your father does. We were not born of prostitution, they went on. We have one father, God." Jesus answered, "If God were your father, you would love me, since I have come here from God. Yes, I have come from him. Not that I came because I chose. No, I was sent by him." The Gospel of the Lord. Just offer a few reading prayers now in response to our readings this morning. So we pray for the church throughout the world, we pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and we pray that the church will always proclaim the truth, because the truth will make people free. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for our parish, we pray for the city, we pray for the old and the housebound, we pray for those who are finding lockdown difficult. We pray for those suffering from depression, those with mental illness. And we ask God to bless them and those who take care of them. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those who are suffering from the COVID disease. We ask God to bless them and to heal them in all the ways they need his healing. We pray for those who look after them, especially those who are tired, and those who are frustrated, and those who have worked hard.
too.
Lord, in your mercy,
yes.
And remember our dead. Pray for all the dead of our families, dead of our community. We ask God to be with them, to take them to the place that He has prepared for them. Pray especially this morning for the ill and weary, and for his family and friends. Lord, in your mercy,
yeah.
We pray for ourselves, that we will take the word of God to heart. The word of God will be able to penetrate into our hearts and minds and attitudes, and that we will respond to the word of God by loving Jesus. Lord, in your mercy,
yeah.
We ask our Blessed Lady, Mother of the Word, to pray for us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death. Amen. Father, we bring you these prayers this morning, and those that we have in our hearts, all our needs and our intentions, we bring them all to you, and we ask you to grant them all through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, receive back these sacrificial offerings which you have given to us to be offered to the honor and glory of your name, and grant that they may become remedies for our healing. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, it is our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we give you thanks as in exaltation, together we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint George and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, and St. Patrick, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have made your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, together we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of the Holy Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a little wave of peace. Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. Blood of Christ. God has brought us to the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, and we have the forgiveness of all our sins. Lord Jesus, I believe that you are really and truly present here in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you sacramentally, but now I am unable to do so. Come, at least spiritually, into my heart. I accept you and embrace you, and unite myself wholly with you. Never permit me to be separated from you. And I ask this through Christ our Lord. Received, bring us heavenly medicine, that they may purge all evil from our hearts and strengthen us with eternal protection. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.